अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन। एज यू नो, वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स रिलेटेड टू द नर्वस एनाटॉमी, नर्वस सिस्टम एनाटॉमी, और वी कैन ऑल्सो कॉल देम न्यूरो एनाटॉमी। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई स्टार्टेड टू इंट्रोड्यूस द नर्वस सिस्टम। Then we, in the next lecture, in the previous lecture, as the previous day, we recorded a lecture that how our nervous system develops. And I started from the basics, that how fertilization occurs and how the embryo will make the neural tube and nervous system. So let me repeat the previous lecture very briefly, and we see what changes were there. So, as we know friends, there was ova, and that ova had met a sperm, right? That ova had met a sperm. So, whenever there is fusion of gametes, both of them are gametes, whenever there is fusion of gametes, we call this process as fertilization. Fertilization, right? I am repeating the previous lecture very briefly. There was fertilization. After fertilization, friends, there was the formation of zygote. And you know, zygote is always diploid or twin. Right? Okay. So, there was zona pellucida around the ova. Then there was the division phase started. And we know this is zona pellucida, and there was two cell stage, zygote started division, there was two cell stage, then after two cell stage there was four cell stage, right? Four cell stage, cells have started proliferation. After four cell stage there was 8 cell or 12 cell stage, right? 8 cell stage, okay. Then after this, what happened that there was the formation of two layers of cells. One layer was the outer layer. This outer layer was known as outer cell mass. And there were some cells which arranged themselves in the center of them. Right? So this was called as outer cell mass. Outer cell mass. And this one was called as inner cell mass. Clear? Okay. Then after this, what had happened that the zona pellucida had started dissolving, and we had still outer cell mass. We had still outer cell mass, and the inner cell mass has been pushed to one side, and some entry of fluids had occurred. Right? And we called this whole structure as blastocyst. Blastocyst. Clear? Okay. Then we know that from the blastocyst, there were some extensions. These are our outer cell masses. And here we have inner cell masses. Then from these there were some extensions. The outer cell mass showed some extensions, and these extensions were called as villi. And some cells in these have lost their cell membranes, and the cytoplasm and the nuclei were around these cells. So inside these cells we could see the nuclei properly and the membranes properly. We call these cells which have their cell membranes, these cells were called as cytotropoblast cells, right friends? And these cells which have lost their cell membranes, these were called cytotropoblast, and these were called as syncytial tropoblasts, right friends? Now let me clear it. Friends, those cells like here, those cells who have lost their cell membranes had released their cytoplasm and nuclei around these cytotrophoblasts. So this area which contain the fluid-like structure, this is called the syncytium. This is called the syncytium. Now what we had done, we had implanted this structure inside the female uterus, right? Okay. This was our female reproductive system, right? Clear. Now, we had implanted this structure here. For example, I am making it very simple. We had implanted this structure here, right? And this was the inner cell mass. There was a connection between the superior endometrium and this structure. So, we had discussed in the previous lecture up to here. And friends, all these changes were occurring during the first week. During first week. Clear? Now we are moving. In today's lecture, we are discussing the changes. In today's lecture, we are discussing the changes which will structure. And these changes are studied in the second week. So, during the first week, these changes were there. And now, in this lecture, we will discuss what happens to these inner cell masses, right? And how the neural tube and the nervous system develops from this structure. Clear, friends? So, let's focus on our lecture. Let's begin. Let me bring out this structure here and see what can we see inside, right? So, we have this structure, right? These are the villi, right? And then there is the inner cell mass, and we also know that there is the syncytium. There is the syncytium. Clear, friends? Now, friends, let's focus on these cells. What happens to these cells? Now, during second week, the beginning of second week, all this inner cell mass will be arranged in two layers. Right? This inner cell mass will be arranged in two layers of cells. Let's see in the diagram. This will be our inner cell mass, right? First layer, upper layer, and the lower layer, right? So this inner cell mass that we are discussing today has been arranged into two layers, right? Friends, this is our upper layer. And this is our lower layer. Clear? I had made it section. So if I draw it clearly, I will draw it here. Now look, friends. Above this layer, there is a cavity. And this cavity is called the amniotic cavity. And below this layer, there is another cavity which is called the yolk sac. This is called yolk sac. This is our amniotic cavity, right? This upper layer is called our epiblast. This upper layer of cells is called epiblast, and this lower layer of cells is called hypoblast. Epiblasts and hypoblasts. Now we can say that this inner cell mass has arranged into two layers. The upper layer is called the epiblast layer and the lower layer is called the hypoblast layer. Like this, look. They have came to here.
and they have arranged in two layers, right? Those cells which we called them here inner cell mass, they have arranged in two layers, the epiblast layer and the hypoblast layer. Above these layers, this cavity is called the amniotic cavity, and below this layer, this cavity is called the yolk sac, right? Okay, now let's move forward. What happens, right? Let me draw this structure from this side. We will see the whole structure, what is it, right? So this structure will be like this. If I draw it completely, this will be our right. This is our epiblast layer. These are the cells. Clear, friends? And this will be our hypoblast layer. Clear? Okay. These are the cells, the epiblast, the hypoblast, and these are the epiblast layer. Right. Above it, there is, you know, amniotic cavity, and below it there is yolk sac. Clear? So this is yolk sac and this is our amniotic cavity. Clear? Now let's see what happens. As this was our previous discussion, we have a separate video on it. You can watch it. Now let's make some changes in these two layers. Friends, as we can see that both of these layers are one above the other. This is the upper layer, and this upper layer, as we have written it here, this upper layer is called the epiblast layer, and this lower layer is called the hypoblast layer, right? So our cells have been arranged into upper and lower. Here I have a section of it here, right? And in this diagram I have drawn it from lateral view. Okay. So now let's see. For example, if these are our two layers, right? This is our epiblast layer and this is our hypoblast layer. Okay. Now this is epiblast, this is hypoblast. Above the epiblast, there is a cavity which is called amniotic cavity. And below here, we have another cavity which is called the yolk sac. Clear, friends? Okay. Now look, what will happen? We are going to make some changes in these two layers. And inshallah, at the end, we will draw the neural tube. And we will develop from it the nervous system. So look, friends. At one end, both these layers will be held tightly, right? At one end, both these layers will be held tightly at this position. This position is called procaudal plate, right? Now let me show it here. At one end, both these layers will be held tightly. For example, at this point, both these layers are held tightly. Okay. What is this? This point is called the procaudal plate. Why it is important? Because this point is going to be the future mouth of the baby. Right? Whenever it will become like this, so here will be cut and it will be the mouth of the baby. Right? So we call this point. Okay, so this end will be the upper end, the cranial end of the baby, and this end will be the caudal end of the baby, right? Let me say it once again. Whenever there is development begin in the two layers, what happens that at one end of this two layer, both these layers hold each other tightly. For example, as I have shown it here, I am going to show it also here. At this point, both these layers are held together, right? They are not going to separate. So this
point is called, this important point is called the prochordal plate. Clear, friends? Let me write it here. What will this prochordal plate make in the future? It will be the mouth of the baby. So from this prochordal plate, what will be developing? The mouth of the baby will be developing. So if from this prochordal plate, mouth develops, what will be this end? This will be the cranial end of the baby, right? So this will be the cranial end. Right. It's very easy. Next. At this point, lower to the prochordal plate, there will be some cells dying off. Some cells will die off, and here a structure like this will be formed. A structure like this will be formed. Clear? So, like this structure. Okay. What has happened here, friends? Here, some cells have been died off through apoptosis, right? They have been vanished. Here also, some cells have been died off. So, here is the primary node formed, and this is the primary streak. Right, friends? So this will be the future mouth of the baby. This will be the future mouth of the baby. And this end will be the caudal end of the baby. Right? So let me show it there in this diagram. Here, friends, some cells will die and like this. Clear? So from this point, cells have been vanished. There is a very small hole. And cells have also diminished from this point, die off from this point. So, this is called, friends, this is called the primary streak. And this point is called the primary node. This is called the primary node. Clear, friends? Okay, let's recap what we have discussed up to now. So friends, the inner cell mass were arranged in two layers, the epiblast and the hypoblast, okay. At one end of the epiblast and hypoblast, both the layers held each other together. This will be the future mouth of the baby. This is called prochordal plate. Next, at the lower end of the prochordal plate, some cells die off at the center and they make a very small hole. This hole is called the primary node, and there was a streak formed, right? At this point also cells die. So there is a streak formed. This is called primary streak. So this end will be the caudal end and this end will be the cranial end, right? So this end will be the caudal end. Clear? So that end where is the primary streak formation, that end will be the caudal end. Either this primary streak forms here or here. That end will be the caudal end of the developing baby. Clear, friends? Okay. Let's move forward. What happens next? So let me clean my diagram there.